Hello everyone, welcome to my channel guys. This is Pranshi Verma. Guys, in today's video we will learn financial derivatives and risk management multiple choice question and answer, and this is a quiz for you guys. आप में से किसी का comment आया था, उन्होंने बोला था मैम please financial derivatives and risk management पर multiple choice question and answer upload कीजिए. So this video is for you and of you. Now let's begin. Question number one, blank space, risk is a loss may occur from the failure of another party to perform according to the terms of a contract. Option A, credit. Option B, currency. Option C, market. Option D, liquidity. So guys, right answer आप comment करके बताइए पहले मुझे. Then right answer here is option A, that is credit. Second question is, financial derivatives include option A, stock, option B, bonds, option C, future, option D, none of these. So right answer of this question is option C, that is future. Question number third, by hedging a portfolio, a bank manager, option A, reduces interest rate risk, option B, increases reinvestment risk, option C, increases exchange rate risk, option D, none of these. Here right answer is option A, reduces interest rate risk. Question number four, a long contract requires that the investors, option A, sell securities in the future, option B, buy securities in the future, option C, hedge in the future, option D, close out his position in the future. Here your right answer is option B, that is buy securities in the future. Question number five, the disadvantages of swaps in that day, option A, lack of liquidity, option B, suffer from default risk, option C, both A and B, and option D is B only. Right answer here is option C, that is both A and B, means option A and option B, they both are included in it. Question six, hedging by buying an option, option A, limits gain, option B, limits losses, option C, limits gain and losses, option D, has no limit, no losses. Here your right answer is option B, that is limits losses. Question number seven, all other things held constant, premium on option will increase when the option A, exercise price increases, option B, volatility of the underlying assets fails, option C, term of maturity increase, option D, both B and C. Here your right option is option C, that is term of maturity increases. Question number eight, an option allowing the owner to sell an asset at a future date is A, option A, put option, option B, call option, option C, forward option, option D, future contract. Right answer here is option A. Guys, यहाँ पर आप अपना understanding level, knowledge level check भी करते रहिए. जब मैं आपको option बता रही हूँ, उसमें आप खुद के mind में click कीजिए कि what is the right answer, please. Question number nine, composite value of trades stock group of secondary market is classified as option A, stock indexes, option B, primary indexes, option C, stock market indexes, option D, limited liability indexes. Here your right option is option C, that is stock market index. Question 10, blank space is the minimum amount which must be remained in a margin account, option A, maintenance margin, option B, variation margin, option C, initial margin, option D, none of these. So here your right answer is option C, that is initial margin. Question number 11, the number of future contract outstanding is called option A, liquidity, option B, float, option C, volume, option D, turnover. So here your right option is option A, that is liquidity. Question number 12, the amount paid for an option is the option A, strike price, option B, discount, option C, premium, option D, yield. So here your right option is option C, that is premium. Okay. Question number 13, futures contracts are more successful than interest rate forward contracts because they, option A, are less liquid, option B, have greater default risk, option C, are more liquid, option D, have an interest rate tied to the discount rate. So here your right option is option C, that is are more liquid. Question number 14. The payrolls of financial derivatives linked to option A. Securities that will be issued in the future. Option B. The volatility of interest rates. Option C. Previously issued security. Option D. None of the above. So here your right option is option C, that is previously issued securities. Question number 15. Which of the following is not a problem with an interest rate forward contracts? Option A. Low interest rate. Option B. Default risk. Option C. Lack of liquidity. And option D is finding a counterparty. So here your right option is option A, that is low interest rate. Okay guys, now let's wind up this particular lecture. See you in the next lecture. Please subscribe to my channel for more videos. Hit the like button. Press the bell icon.